He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Back in the wonderland of physics that is your garage, you and your friend decide to construct a simple pendulum. This string has a length of 2 meters, and the ball at the end has a mass of 0.5 kilograms. You then try to make various predictions about the system. If you release the pendulum from an angle of 35 degrees below the horizontal, where will the ball be traveling the fastest, and what will its velocity be at that point? To answer this, we need to know about potential and kinetic energies, as well as some trigonometry. So check out those tutorials first, if you need to. Otherwise, go for it. Just as with an object in freefall, this pendulum will always have some amount of potential energy and some amount of kinetic energy. Just before releasing, it has only potential energy, as kinetic energy is the energy of motion, and it isn't moving. Once released, the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy until it reaches the lowest point, where there is zero potential energy and only kinetic energy, and then back up to the other side, converting all the kinetic energy back into potential energy as it slows down, until for a single instant it has zero kinetic energy once again. This clearly means that the point where the ball will be moving the fastest is right at the bottom, where kinetic energy is at a maximum. And specifically, this amount of kinetic energy will be equal to the initial potential energy. So let's calculate that first. This will be equal to mgh, and we can take the bottom of the swing as being zero height. So what is the height at the point of release? To find that, we need to construct a triangle. We have this angle, 35 degrees, and we have the hypotenuse, as the string length is always equal to 2 meters. We want to know this opposite side, which we can get by using sine. Sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse, so sine of 35 equals this distance x over 2. We evaluate the sine, multiply by 2, and we get 1.15 meters. Now that we have this distance, it is easy to get the height from the lowest point, because when vertical, this length is 2 meters. So this length must be 2 meters minus 1.15 meters, or 0.85 meters. So there is our h, and we have m and g, 0.5 kilograms, 9.8 meters per second squared, and 0.85 meters. That will give us 4.17 joules. Now, as we said, the potential energy at this point will equal the kinetic energy at this point, and kinetic energy equals 1/2 mv squared. So once here, 4.17 joules equals 1/2 the mass times velocity squared. So we multiply by 2, divide by the mass, and then take the square root, and we should get 4.08 meters per second. Plenty fast enough to scare your cat or whatever else you weirdos intended to do with it. Thanks to physics. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.